Hello and good day. We'll make use of a simple line tracker as an alternative to our distance sensor. So again, our distance sensor, the ultrasonic distance sensor, is capable of detecting objects around 4 meters, up to 4 meters. But for other purposes, if there's no need to detect objects or movement that far, we can always use the line tracker. And this line tracker basically works using infrared and detects for the amount of reflection that is received by the receiver. So for the wiring, you have the following connections. You have the G for ground, B++ for the 5 volts, and S for the signal. Let's connect it to our setup. And before we proceed, it's basically the same connection with your robot. Same connection. So no need to disassemble your robot. But for demonstration purposes, let's use this basic setup. So I'll connect it to 5 volts. This is 5 volts. I'll connect it to B++ or VCC. We have to be very careful with the connection. And then I'll connect ground or G to ground. And the wire here is connected to A1, also known as pin number 2. Connect it there. There you go. Alright. Wait, it actually should point to the surface. And then I'll connect it to my computer. And all right, so if there is reflection, you should see the LED light up and the signal that it should be sending back to the microcontroller should be 0. If there's no reflection, then the signal that it should be sending back to the microcontroller should be 1. Currently, it's 0. This is 1. 0 and 1. 0 and 1. Let's write the code. So let's say that you would like to detect if there's movement away from the sensor. So if the object is lifted, so that becomes 1, and otherwise it will remain 0. So this is great on, well, you can also use this on doors, windows, or anything, you know, that you would like to check for movement at a short distance. So let's check our code. Let's start with declaring our variables. Let's start with constant. So the LED is the same connection, 15, again also known as A1. And then for our speaker, it's connected to 3. And then we have our line tracker. L tracker for line tracker. It will be equal to 16, also known as A2. And for setup, pin mode for the LED will be output. The speaker will be output. L tracker on on the other hand will be input. Alright, but the code will be very simple. If there's movement, then we would like the speaker and the LED lit up. So, if digital read, L tracker is equal to 1, take note of the indention, take note of the grouping of the number of branches, what we want to do is we want to switch on the LED and the speaker. Otherwise, or else, we'll switch it off. Let's check the connection, tools, board should be Arduino Nano, processor is either the old bootloader or the first one, the 80Mega T28P, port is 4. In my case is 4. Again, let's double check. I'll disconnect. I'll check the ports again. Alright, I have 12 and 13. If I connect the board to my computer, the last one that will appear is the one that you should select. Alright, let's check if this will upload. I'll click the upload button. I'll save later. It's uploading. It's trying to upload, but it's not uploading, so I have to make changes to my setup. So I'll just press escape to stop. Tools. I'll change the processor back to 80Mega T28P and upload. Okay, done uploading. So let's check. Alright. If there's some movement, the alarm should go off. Okay, so now it's time for you to try it on your own kit. Thank you.